that bloody movie with coffee. And today's episode, we will be talking about 2019 and how movie sucks today. As you know, I mean, in today's, this year's movies have really sucked really bad. I mean, throughout the years, you have seen your ups, you have seen your downs with some of these movies, but pretty much it's pretty bad. I mean, I don't know what Hollywood is thinking. I don't know what they're trying to do, but I honestly believe that they're running out of ideas and they're sitting there trying to scramble and come up with all these other ideas. And honestly, I think we're done with the remakes, we're done with the sequels, and let's get together and try to make some originals, which needs to be made, you know. So again, Hollywood in 2019 with films suck. I mean, don't get me wrong, they're coming out with Toy Stories 4, you know, animation, you can always create sequels for, kids love it, it's a family thing, great. But like, you know, Men in Black, rebooting that and changing the whole premise of that and just kind of changing the characters and just recreating it, and granted, it may be a totally different story from the Will Smith version, but you know, once you do something one way and you try to redo it again, it's never the same. So to me, I'm not gonna go see it. And I mean, no disrespect to the actors. I think both of them are excellent actors in that film, but I still think that there's a lot of other ideas they could come out with. You know, rather than playing it safe, I think they should start to take chances on other films. But that's just my opinion. But again, being an independent filmmaker, you have so many other films out there that get, you know, pushed under the radar, stories that are like you never heard of before. Even some of the films that I've seen overseas that hasn't even touched America is way better than some of the stuff that's coming out now in Hollywood. Now, don't get me wrong, 20, 30 years ago, Hollywood had some good movies. But in today's market, in today's world, I feel like the production value has dropped because technically they're looking at more of the CGI and the graphics and the special effects and enhancing that more than really the story of a movie, like the story base, you know. It's not story driven, it's more action, let's get to the action, let's get to the middle of the story. There's no backstories, you know, you don't even know why this character is there, how he came to be, you know. I mean, like, there's no build up, and I think we as the audience and as an independent filmmaker, we appreciate the build up. We appreciate you take us on this little ride, this little journey, where we discover what the story is going to be about, who's the villain, where he came from, how he became the villain, why is he after this person. You gotta have some structure, and I feel like Hollywood has stepped away from that, but independent filmmakers, they haven't. They just haven't been given the chance to voice their opinion, voice their stories, and been able to come out. I think that Hollywood's gonna have to open the gates and just let these independent filmmakers come in and do their things. You know, after a while, the old saying says, how many times can you eat the same cereal? Eventually, you're gonna get tired of that cereal and you're gonna want something else. So, in today's episode, Make That Bloody Movie with Coffee, I will tell you the coffee of the night that I'm drinking. It's just a regular, I think it was called Nestle coffee, instant coffee, nothing fancy. Just get me by while I do my creative work at night, while all my family members are sleeping and I can concentrate. So I'm just having a Nestle coffee. Back to what we were saying, you know, Hollywood needs to change their format. What they're going with is not effective like it used to be. I think they need to not reinvent the wheel, but change it or modify it. If you tell me, you know. Again, there's gonna be a lot of haters out there. A lot of people say they disagree with what I'm saying, but it's gonna get to a point where everybody's gonna get fed up with superhero movies. How many superhero movies can you really do? I mean, you could do a whole bunch, but where are the good stories? I mean, come on, where are the based on true stories or fiction stories where, you know, it's recreated, but it's really good, you know? It's not a remake, it's just something that's put together in a way that you never heard or never seen it before, never even told. I think that's what they need to look at, those type of stories. And I think if Hollywood were to do that, things would change for them. Again, Netflix is taking over in that market. They're going into that, working with independent filmmakers, And I think that's where we need to be, is like, give us underdogs the shot that we need, because I think you'll be very surprised and impressed to see what's happening. So, saying goodnight, farewell. Thank you for joining me on this Make That Bloody Movie with Coffee in this episode of 2019. Hollywood movies suck. All right, guys. See you later. Thank you for watching. Always a pleasure. Always thank you. Don't forget to subscribe. See that button on the bottom? Subscribe. I got more stuff coming for you. All right, peace and love. All right, bye. I'm out of here.